गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर 21, अमेर फोर्ट टेल्स इट्स स्टोरी. सो इन दिस चैप्टर बेसिकली व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इज देयर इज अ फोर्ट कॉल्ड एज अमेर फोर्ट. फोर्ट मीन्स अ प्लेस वेयर द किंग्स एंड महाराजाज वेर लिविंग इन दैट टाइम. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द फोर्ट. So today we are going to see about one such type of fort, that is the Amer fort, and what all things it contains. So Amer fort, where it is? It is standing in the foothill of Aravalli Hills, just 11 kilometers. From Jaipur, Rajasthan. So, if somebody is going to ask where you can see Amer Fort, you can simply say it is situated in the foothill of Aravalli Hills. It is just 11 kilometers from Jaipur, Rajasthan. We all are acquainted about Jaipur, that it is situated in Rajasthan only. So, If you want to visit Amer Fort, what you have to do? First, you have to reach Rajasthan. From there, to Jaipur, and from Jaipur, you have to move 11 kilometers to reach this Aravalli Hills, where you can find this Amer Fort. So, this fort, this Amer Fort, was a very happy home. It was a home for many Rajput Maharajas and their families for several years. Okay, many Maharajas came, they reside over there with their family, and it was a very good, it was having a very good atmosphere, happy atmosphere, so that people were very much happy. Okay, so many people called it as Amer Palace. Okay, now how much old it is? It is around 600 years old. Okay, 600 years old. And it was built by Raja Mansingh I. Who was the builder of this fort? He was Raja Mansingh One. And why this one is? Because he was the first king. After that, the second king was again Maharaja Mansingh II. Like this. Suppose in your attendance sheet, if the names are being repeated, the teacher doesn't call you with the surname. What she is saying? A1, B2, A3, like this. She is calling. So like that only Raja Mansingh I. Then again the successor of him was Raja Mansingh II, like this. Okay. And it was made up of red stone. Okay. Red stone and marbles. Okay. It is made up of red sandstones or marbles. Okay. Now, let's go inside this fort. We have seen all this, the history of this fort, that who has made it, where it is being made, and it is made up of what and what. Now, let's move inside the fort. So, it is having, basically it is having three main parts. The very first part is your Diwan-e-Aam. As the name suggests, Aam means for general people. It was a meeting place for the general people. The king or the Maharaja will be sitting at the highest point, and all the public, the general people, they will come to this area and they will have a talk with the king or the Maharaja. And they will share their problems, they will share their happiness with the Maharaja and he will try to solve their problems. Okay. Now, second one, second place is Diwane Khas. Diwane Khas. Or otherwise called as a Sheesh Mahal. Or Sheesh Mahal. Or called as a mirror. Mirror Palace. And what this place is? This place was the meeting hall for the important people. Suppose or some other king, other state or other place king wants to meet him, or their office staff wants to meet him. So they were meeting in the Diwane Khas. Only the important peoples were coming to this place and having the meeting over there. Okay, so that is the reason it is called as Diwane Khas. Number three was Sukh Nivas. As the name suggests, Sukh Nivas means resting place, the place of comfort where the king was relaxing. Okay, now this is the three part. Let's enter the palace. So while entering the palace, the very first thing what you will get, a gate called as a Suraj Kot. It is the entry point. It is the entry of the palace. Suraj Kot. Okay. It is so called because it is facing toward the rising of the sun. Okay. It's faced toward the east side, where from where the sun is rising. Okay. Now you have entered the Suraj Kot. Now where you were going? To the Jalep Chowk. The name is very interesting. Jalep Chowk. Okay, it is the place where the soldiers were assembling, where all the soldiers were standing. It is the Jalep Chowk. Okay, now what the Maharaja was doing in the Jalep Chowk? He was seeing the procession of the soldiers, how they were parading, how they were practicing and all that thing. All things were done in the Jalep Chowk. Now, if we will go to the left side of the Suraj Kot, what you will find? We will find several shops, handicraft shop, where you can buy several things. Okay. And on the right side, you will get Sila Devi Temple. Sila Devi Temple. On the right side, you will find. Okay. And the Singh Pole. Okay. And the Singh Pole. As the name suggests, Singh Pole, that is your lion gate. It is called as again your lion gate. Okay, so this is the entrance, all about the entrance that we have to go towards it. Then you will be getting Diwane Aam. Then you can move on further and further. Okay, so next we will do the next.